press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
Hello everyone and welcome back to our social study class. I hope that you all are doing your work properly, okay, and following these videos and learning at your homes. I hope that, isn't it? So here in the previous class we already learned about what? You have any ideas what we learned? Yes, we learned about the water, isn't it? What the water we drink in the previous class. Water is very precious, now yes, for living things. Water is very precious for living things. Without water we can't imagine our life. Okay, life is not possible on earth without water. So not only human beings need water, but also plants, animals also need water. So this is all about the previous class. Okay, so here now we are going to learn about the new chapter. Okay, so it's very interesting chapter. So now we are going to learn about the my country. You have any idea which country you are living? Yes, which continent you are living? You have any idea? Yes, we all are living in the continent of Asia, isn't it? And which continent, which country you are living? Yes, we are living in the India. Which state? Yes, Karnataka. And which district? Davanagere. Okay, here now we are going to learn about my country. Okay, in this chapter we are learn about what? Yes, central government and the state government and the names of union territories. Okay, so first we know that India is very big country. Okay, so we all know that now India is very big country. So India is the seventh largest country in the world. So compared to the other countries, India comes under the seventh place. Okay, India comes under the seventh place. India is the seventh largest country in the world. Okay, so here there are over how many peoples are living? Yes, 1 billion of people are living, like 10 crore of people are living. Okay, so here the 100 crore of people are living here. How many crores? 100 crore of people living here. Okay, so 1 billion. Okay, so there is a difference between billion. Okay, so how many? Yes, 1 billion. 1 billion. Okay, 100 crores of people are living in India. So here we are, this much of population we have. Okay, so here, so India is the second most populous country in the world. Area wise seventh, but population wise second. Okay, China is first in the population wise. So here India was under the British rule for more than how many years? More than 100 years. You all know now, British rule over the India, isn't it? So there is a big struggle, isn't it, before 1947. We know it, there are famous revolt against the British, we know, isn't it? So here so many freedom fighters fight against the British rule, isn't it? So here India is rule under the British rule for about 100 years. Okay, after years fighting, after the struggling, okay, so this is very big story of struggling against British rule, isn't it? So after struggling and protest and the persuasions, India became independent on 15th August 1947. Okay, so when we got the independence? Yes, 15th August 1947 we got the independence, isn't it? So every year we are celebrating now Independence Day. Yes, when? 15th August, isn't it? So when we got the independence? 15th August 1947. 47 we got the independence. It is not easy of getting the independence. It's have very big struggling story, isn't it? So many freedom fighters struggles, so many intellectuals, peoples are struggles, and also so many freedom fighters fight against the British rule. Okay, so here independence give us the right to choose of our own government. After the independence, we got the rights to choose our own government. Okay, so before independence, what happened? We have to rule under the British government. So what they want to give the rights now, we had to, that much only we had to take it, isn't it? So we don't have, every person don't have the rights to vote. Okay, so now not only for vote but also for other rights, we don't have the rights. We are like slaves, isn't it? So we all are slaves at the time of British rule. Okay, so in Indians like a slaves, we are, so all Indians are living like a slaves before independence, I am telling. Okay, after independence we got the rights to choose our own government. Okay, so here and our country is in our own way. So before what happened, we have to follow the rules and regulation of the British country now, British rules now. So here after the independence we form our own rules and regulation also, isn't it? So and also we got our we have the right to vote now. So and also we have to choose our own government now. So here there are two types of government we can see, isn't it? So how many types of government we can see? Two types of government we can see in our country. So what do you mean by government? You have any idea? Government, the group of people with the authority, power. A group of people have the power to govern a country. Government means a group of people have the authority to govern a country, or a state, a particular ministry in a office. So a group of people have the power to govern a country. So like that, there are two types of government we can see. First one is central government, and then second one is state government. First one is two types of government we can see. Two types government so first one is central government. Next one is state government. So there is two types of government, central government and then state government. So first we are going to learn about the central government. So the both government are working for what? Both works together. Ensure that the people are happy or not. So they are working for the welfare of the people. The government is working for the welfare of the people. So first one is central government. You know, what do you mean by government? A group of people, have the authority to govern a country or a state. In a particular ministry in an office. So here first one is central government. Central government which works in the central level. So its work in the central level is called central government. Why we call the central government? For its work for the central. So that's why central government. So the central government office are located in New Delhi. It's our capital now. New Delhi is our capital now. So it's located in a New Delhi, which is the capital of our country. So New Delhi is our capital, na? Yes. So here, the president, the prime minister, and other minister and senior officials of the central government operate from the Delhi. Who are operate from the Delhi? Yes, the president, prime ministers, and other minister and then senior officials of the central government. They operate from the central government. Okay, so operate from the New Delhi. Who comes under the central government? Yes, so they are comes who are comes under the state government, central government? Yes, president, prime minister, other ministers, senior officials of the central government operate from the Delhi. Okay, the central government is responsible for the progress. Okay, it has some responsibility now. Yes, so the central government is responsible for the progress, interest, and the welfare of the entire country. So it's responsible for the entire country. Okay, all over the entire country, it is responsible for the entire country. Okay, so for the progress, this central government see the progress is going on or not. Okay, so they introduce the new schemes to the country. Okay, and also its work for the welfare of the people. Okay, welfare of the entire country. And it also solve the problems of all parts of our country. So central government solve the problems. For example, if state government means states are fighting with each other, means so central government have the power, authority to solve the problem. Okay, it solve the problem of entire country. Okay, so it solved the entire problem and also worked for the progress of the people. Okay, so next one is state government. Okay, state government. So India is a big country, that makes it hard for the central government to take care of everyone. So it's very hard to central government now to take care of everyone, isn't it? For example, if there is any head in the institution, they can't take care of everyone, each and every one students now. So this the head one is appoints the teachers now to take care of everyone like that. So each and everyone can take care, isn't it? So that's why so it's very hard for the central government to take care of each and everyone, isn't it? So how many states we have? Yes, now we have 28 states now. It's not possible for the central government to take care each everyone, isn't it? So here it's very hard to central government. So India is divided into smaller areas called state. So that's why India is divided into smaller areas. We can see it now. Yes, Tamil Nadu, Kerala, Maharashtra, and Jammu and Kashmir. There are 28 states now. So divided into smaller states. Okay, it's all comes under our country, but it's divided into small areas to run administration, isn't it? So here every state has its own state government. So here every area have the state government, okay, that runs it. So here this central government take care of all whole country now. So here, so it's not possible to take care of each and everyone. So this central government divided into small areas. So states, like, so states have its own government, okay, it's run it. Okay, here there are 28 states, we can see it, isn't it? So if every state has its own elected government. So every state have its own elected government. So in the states we can see the government now. Yes, who is the present prime minister of our country? S, Narendra Modi. So you had to know it everything. So who is the present president? Yes, you have any idea who is the present president in the central government? Yes, Ramnath Kovind is the present president of our country. So, and like that, vice president is also here, isn't it? Who is the vice president present? Yes, Venkaiah Naidu is the vice president. Okay, so here there are how many states? Yes, there are 28 states. Now we can see it, before 29, na? So now we can see the 28th state. Okay, and those states have its own government. Okay, so and also elected government also here. So like consists of who? Yes, governors, chief ministers, other ministers and officers. We can see now. Governor also we can see now. Yes, and also chief ministers, other ministers we can, and also officers we can see here. Okay, they live and work in the state capital. So which is our capital? Which is our state capital? Yes, Bengaluru, isn't it? So in our Bengaluru we can see the, yes, state government. Okay, so here state government consists of governor, chief ministers, senior officers, and then officers we can see. Okay, so here, and also we can see the union territories also. Union territories also we can see. There are also small areas in India, okay, and run directly central government. There are very small areas are there. So the central government runs the directly its central government runs there. So here we can see the central state government now, but in the small areas, somehow small areas, so that areas run directly by the central government is called union territories. Okay, so here Delhi is one of them. So Delhi is also a union territory. Okay, so since it is our capital, Delhi is called the national capital territory. So here Delhi is called as a national capital territory is called Delhi, isn't it? So then each union territory has its own local government and central government helps to run them. So each union territory have the local government. Okay, so central government helps to them to run administration. Okay, so here you have any idea about the union territories? Yes, so Andaman Nicobar, Lakshadweep. Okay, so here Puducherry, Chandigarh, there are so many, there are non-union territories we can see here. Okay, so here there are government have the organs also. Okay, the government have three organs, like judiciary, okay, legislature, and then yes, executive. Okay, executive we can see the three organs. So here legislature consists of parliament. We called it parliament now. We can see in the Delhi now. Yes, parliament consists of whom? Yes, consists of the president and then two houses, Lokasabha Sabha and then Rajya Sabha. Parliament consists of two houses. Okay, so president and then two houses, like in the legislature. In the executive, whom we see? The branches of the president, vice president, council of ministers, lead by the prime ministers. Okay, and in the judiciary we can see the supreme court, high court, then district court, local courts. Okay, so in the judiciary we can see it. Okay, so three organs of our government, legislature, executive, and then judiciary is the three organs of our government. One organ makes the law, okay, and another one make the implement the law, and the judiciary, what this is, it just supervise the both the, yes, organs. Okay, so here Karnataka is have the Karnataka is our state government, isn't it? So here in the state there is a two houses. Okay, we can see the two houses now. Which are they? Yes, Vidhana Sabha and then Vidhana Parishad. Lower house and then upper house, we can see it. Okay, so this is all about the central government and state government. Okay, so government means what? Government means what? Yes, answer it first. What is government? Yes, what is government? Government means, yes, a group of people with the authority to govern a country or a state. Okay, so now present, how many states we can see? We can see the 28 states. Okay, so the capital, which is the capital of our country? New Delhi is our capital of our country. And then which is the seventh largest country in the world? Which is the seventh largest country in the world? Yes, India is the seventh largest country in the world. And then when did India got independence? Yes, 15th August 1947 we got independence. Okay, so here this is all about my country. In my country, in this chapter, we already learnt about the central government, state government and then union territories. So here this is all about the government. Okay, I hope that you all are understand this, and thank you so much.